We also want to give our fictitious people a salary. And we'll do that the same way that we calculated the ages, and that will be by using that random number. Each of our employees are going to make between $25,000 and $75,000, so I'm using a random number between 25 and 75 times 1,000. And copying that down for all of them. And because this is the random number, we need to highlight them. Copy. And now paste special. Numbers only. Make this whole row dollar signs. We can center this, and we're going to use a little paintbrush to make salary the same as the others. Whoops, we want that thing centered too. Being the owner of this company, now we want to know what departments have for their total salaries. Now we could put in the filters as we saw earlier and filter by each department and go through and get the subtotals for that, or we could just go into data, subtotals. Now in here we want to group by our department. Now we want to calculate the subtotals for the salaries, and we want to sum them all together. So we click OK, and it sorted them by accounting, then the IT department, then management, and here is our totals here. It added up all the salaries. We got $617,000 for the accounting, the IT department $361,000, management $144,000, and so on. Then we hit our grand total and we get this pound signs because this column's not big enough. Now we can see $1,469,000 in salaries for our company. Now when we create subtotals, we also have these extra numbers here depending on the number of subtotals we use. We've got three here, so if we go down to the level one, the main level is just our grand total. Level two is our department level total, and level three is all, and you can break it up down here too, just certain departments show all of the data in the department or less, more or less, and then clicking this one brings it all out. Another thing we might want to do is to add the count of the number of people in each department. You know, here it's easy to tell that there's only three in security and two in marketing, but we may have hundreds or thousands in a particular group. So the easiest way to add that in there is data, subtotals. There's our first group. Now adding a second group in there, we're going to also group by department. And since we're already using salary, we'll just group by department and count up the number of salaries in each department. Clicking OK, now we see our accounting department has 11, IT has 8, and there's 3 in our management, 2 in our marketing, and 3 in security. And they give you a number of choices there to pick and choose from. But that's basically how the grouping works.